The hottest mix starts now. From the 605 to worldwide, it's DJ Strick. DJ Strick. It's DJ Strick.
The Mega Mix starts now. The best DJ is mixing it up.
Oh, yeah. We got Waide.
Cardi B.
From Lord Rapid Funnies. To speak at us and get it done.
Hello.
The hottest DJ is in the mix. DJ Strick.
Oh my god. All right, dude. I just had to do my introduction and that was fucking funny as hell. Dude, everybody out there right now, you all listen to DJ Strick at the DJ Strick Show. I'm coming straight from Ogallala, South Dakota. And homeboy is actually in Rapid City with me live. So Waide of North Rapid Funnies, say what's up.
What's up? This is Waide from North Rapid Funnies. How's it going, everybody?
Dude, I'm trying to hold that fucking laugh in.
All right, I'll
that
quit.
Is the fucking best fucking. Fucking.
Okay, I'll quit doing that now.
All right.
All right.
Should we start? Restart again? No, fuck it. No, let's just let it go. Fuck it.
Let's run with it. All right.
Run with it. All right. We got Waide. One of the partners of North Rapid Funnies right here, right now. So speak on them.
How's it going, everybody? This is Waide. Hope everybody's doing well. It is a beautiful Saturday evening. Actually, it is early Sunday morning, where after 1 a.m.
Yes.
I suppose at this time, everybody's out at the bars, just getting shit-faced and having a good old time.
Are trying to run to the bars like, hey, hurry up. Maybe they make a beer run.
Yeah, that last-minute beer run before they stop selling here, which is probably in about 15 to 30 minutes. So you guys better hurry.
Hurry up.
Yeah. All right. So my first topic at hand I would like to talk about is football. Of course, I am a Steelers fan, and I would like to touch up on the current 7-0 Steelers taking on the 2-6 Cowboys over in Cowboy Stadium tomorrow. Mm-hmm. So I think it'd be a pretty good game for the Steelers. This one might cement them into the playoffs because they're starting to look at playoff scenarios now.
Okay, I have no comeback for that because you're on your own. It's your boy, DJ Strick. I have no team or, you know, so I leave it up to my boys right here.
You sound like you've been through the desert on a horse with no name.
Yes.
It felt good to be out of the rain, huh?
Yes.
All right, so moving forward, I had to work a late shift. Just got off of work not too long ago. So just kind of just sipping some beers, enjoying the night. How about you?
It's the weekend, right?
Yeah.
Can you hear me?
Yeah, I can hear you.
Do you like my voice? Yeah.
Oh, your voice is fucking hot.
Say it again, puppy. Say it again, puppy.
Again.
Yeah. All right. It's your boy right here. Again, Miguel John, a.k.a. DJ Strick, all the way in Ogallala, South Dakota, having fun by himself, sipping some drinks, you know, chilling, and we going live right now with
Waide from North Rapid Funnies.
He caught on like 2 seconds later. But seriously, so, North Rapid Funnies, come on, speak on that. How you guys been doing? I mean, is it still progressing, or is it you still? I know you guys have to begin hate mail.
Yeah. Yeah, the page is actually is progressing really well. We, excuse me, that's that beer burp. We do get some, we get some fan mail about how our page is doing and whatnot. I guess some people say that we're a little bit intrusive with sensitive content, you know, but the thing is that our page is not for the sensitive. It's not for those that take offense so easily. I mean, our page is a meme page. I mean, a lot of it is satire. A lot of it is about funny things, you know, that happen to a lot of people nowadays. I mean, hey, funny things happen to me too. I mean, come on, I could tell you when I was 5 years old, I was chased by a goose in Canyon Lake when I ran out of bread.
Okay.
I ran out of bread to feed it. Yeah. I backed up towards my stepdad, and it just kept going. And then finally, I took off running, and there it was, fucking hauling ass right behind me.
Oh wow! So did you get pecked?
No, I didn't get pecked. My stepdad was able to finally chase it off, and then I was able to finally run to the car.
Okay.
Yeah, it was hilarious. I could tell you about the time my mom caught a fish and I was right behind her, and then it hit my shoulder and I screamed my head. I was like about 6 years old at the time.
Oh well.
Yeah.
Oh, he's going way back. He's going way back when he was a little way.
Yeah, life was interesting, but you know what? Hey, life's always interesting. I'll tell you that much right now.
You're telling me. You know, like I said, I'm Miguel John, DJ Drake. I'm 42 years old. So I'm almost old as shit. Almost. I said almost.
Well, I'm about to hit 40, so I'm pretty much in the same boat.
So your balls are gray too?
Yeah. Oh, God. They're getting there.
We don't... See, we're on the podcast. Chill. Should we actually put this out there, or should we talk about our balls? I don't know.
Well, hey, you started the ball conversation first.
You want to see mine?
No, good. You just
do. They want to see ours. That's the question. Do they want to see ours?
Yeah, that's a good question right there.
So, if you want to see our balls, email us at Unstop Records with a Z at the end, unstoprecords@gmail.com. Then you can see our balls.
If you do it,
I'll pay you $1.
He'll give you a shot.
Give me a shot. Okay, I think we kind of went off with the subject anyways.
Okay, so we're off the ball subject finally that DJ Strick obviously started.
Yes, I like balls.
Yeah.
So, I don't like balls that way. Sorry.
Hey, you said that.
Hey. You got my back.
I got your back, but remember you said it though.
Yes. So... Wait. God. Oh, let's go.
All right, so everybody, about this hour, whoever's listening, and if you're drinking that drink, send us an email. Let you know what you're drinking and why you like it. I'm just drinking some beer, and I'm drinking a Bud Light Limerita. I started late. I started about midnight. So,
well, see, people, the reason why he started late is because he has a job. He works. He does pay his bills, pays his rent, light bill. So that's the reason why this dude right here, you know, Waide, you know, my homeboy. Hombre.
I'm not trying to sound better than everybody else, but you know what I mean.
Oh, no. It's not bragging. It's just saying that's what you do in life.
Yeah.
You know, but you got motherfuckers on Facebook and Instagram and everything. Look at me. I do this. It's like, yeah, you're supposed to do that. But you got this motherfucker right here doing his shit. You know, just at least let him have his beer. Let him chill, relax, and have fun. Fuck.
Well, everybody, I think everybody deserves to relax and have fun once in a while.
Oh, huh.
Yeah. So, let's see. Have you watched anything good on Netflix nowadays?
Netflix. Actually, I'm going to ask you the same questions. All right. Let's forget about the Netflix question he said. So, okay. The same thing I said to Gina, one of our personalities that we have here on the D-District shit. Miguel, slow down.
And how many have you had?
Which one?
Jeez.
Oh, dude. Anyways, going out to Gina, Project Celebrity. I asked her these same questions, so I'm going to ask you the same ones. All right, ready?
All right. Yeah, go for it.
What is your favorite word?
My favorite word is... My favorite word is absolutely.
All right, you took so long to say that. So, what is your favorite word?
You know, I don't know. I don't have a favorite word, I guess.
Oh, anyways, check it out. What turns you on?
Okay, my favorite word is fuck.
All right, so what turns you on?
What turns me on is, I guess what turns me on is, how do I put this? What turns me on is, I don't know, I guess I never thought that deep into that. What turns me on is humor.
Cool.
Yeah, because I really think that somebody with a sense of humor, you know, is somebody that's not very narrow-minded, somebody that's that can think outside the box. And what they do is they don't get too sensitive, because since the fact that I like to joke around a lot, I'd like for them to laugh with me too. That's my biggest thing right there, is humor.
Nice. So, what is your favorite cuss word?
Well, my favorite cuss word is fuck.
Fuck. I was going to say, I don't give a fuck. Fuck.
Yeah. What the fuck? What kind of dumb fuckery is this? Or what kind of shit fuck is... What kind of shit fuck thing is going on around here? You know what I mean?
The fuck?
There was something I seen a Facebook video where this guy had this, this guy was a DJ and he had this music going on and it had this beginning and it sounded really weird. And then, yeah, everybody was listening to it and all of a sudden it goes, "Let me in, I wanna fuck."
I think I've seen that one.
Yeah, because it started off like, ooh, ah. You remember that one?
Yeah, I think so.
Let me in, I don't want to fuck.
Yeah. Okay, yeah. On a scale of 1 to 10, how weird are you?
I'll probably put myself at an 8.
What are you not very good at?
I'm not very good at...
Bunning. No, actually, you are good at that.
That's going to raise questions with other people, buddy. Okay, so you asked me what I was good at, right?
Good at what? Your sexiness?
Okay, well, there's a couple of things I'm good at. Are you ready?
Hold on. And okay. What are you not very good at?
Okay, yeah. Well, all right. Well, I guess what I'm not very good at is art. Yeah, I'm a shitty drawer. I mean, I can't draw a straight line. Excuse me. I can't draw a straight line. I mean, I need a straight edge to draw a straight line and whatnot. And I guess my art's not very good because, I mean, I can draw a ho- I mean, if you ask me to draw a horse, that shit's going to come out with eight legs. Yeah.
Well, if it has eight legs, then it has two dicks. Poor horse.
I don't know, though. The horse might be glad because they're going to have two mares at the same time, probably. I don't know.
Yeah, but you got to think about his girlfriend. The one.
Well, the horse can have a threesome.
Oh, shit, there you go. See, everybody, he's listening. He's actually thinking outside the bun. See, thinking outside the box, not the bun.
Oh, jeez. Oh, sounds like you need to get something taken care of tonight, bud.
I'm trying to. Anyway, so Waide of North Traffic Funnies. Oh shit! Did I lose you?
Oh, I'm here.
Oh yeah. Did you drop your phone?
No, I didn't drop my phone. I'm sorry. I'm still here. I had to scratch my ear that my earbud mic were in. So.
Well, he must have some big ass ears because. The way that sounded right there, guys, it was like...
I grabbed the bike part by accident.
Y'all hear that? Y'all hear that? That's what happens if you have big-ass ears.
I know. I wish I could fucking hear China, but I guess I can't.
I can hear a man farting China.
Really?
Yes.
Can you hear that mariachi music in Mexico?
No, I'm not that. I'm not that. No. All right. So, are we done with the questions, or? Because seriously, no. I was actually having fun.
All right, go ahead. No, I'm good. I'm good. I'm ready for more questions. You got more?
All right. Here we go. It's a Waide of North Rabbit Funnies. So, if you guys get a chance, check them out on the link down below. Or these guys. Seriously, these guys are fucking funny as hell. Seriously, when you guys check out their page, they are assholes, but they're funny as fuck. At the same time, people get offended, which I don't understand.
As far as offense goes, I mean, offense is what you make of it. I mean, if you are sensitive, the page is not for you. That's practically how I can put it in a nutshell.
Yeah, and you notice... You get hits, hits in the wrong way. Like, oh my God, that's offended me. Click. Right?
Yeah.
And same with our homeboy, Daniel. Daniel Koloff? Koloff?
Koloff?
Yeah, he's just doing his own page. He's doing his own fucking Facebook, and he still get hits. When I say hits, I mean like haters. And they still fucking block him. I was like, what the fuck?
You know, I mean, I understand where he's coming from because I'll do that too. I'll post non North Rapid Funny content on my own Facebook page. And then, yeah, I get I'll get hits on mine too. I mean, I'll get supporters and I'll get haters too. I mean, I understand where he's coming from with that.
Yeah, but most of the time he gets blocked, so he has to do a jail, FB jail, you know.
Uh-huh.
You know. So it's somebody on his page who is doing that kind of shit to him.
Yeah, somebody is reporting all this shit, sounds like.
And that's what sucks. We don't know who it is.
Here's the thing. If you don't like something, just scroll past it, or you know what, just hit the unfollow or hit the unfriend
exactly,
button.
Exactly, everybody. Right Don't there.
Go reporting shit because of your own feelings getting hurt. I mean, you're ruining it for everybody else.
Yeah, exactly. As it up to your part, you know, shit.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, dude, I'm fucking getting drunk.
Yeah, I know. I'm feeling it. I'm feeling it, too. I've had three beers now. I mean, I'm about to hit this 8.0 alcohol Lime Arena.
Oh, shit. He's trying to be an alcoholic.
Shit. I'm a drinker. Alcoholics go to meetings.
Hey, shit. You know what? He actually says something fucking true.
I say a lot of true shit.
All right, check it out. What are some specific roadblocks to watch out for?
All right, specific roadblocks to watch out for are people that like to waste time. Never have your time wasted by somebody who doesn't want to be your friend, or somebody that doesn't want to, you know, be there for you and care about you. Another roadblock to watch out for is somebody who isn't creative, because if you run into somebody that's not creative, mm-hmm. Someone that's so, I call it normalized. I mean, you're not gonna, the person's gonna be dull. You're gonna be miserable right along with them. That's practically how it's gonna be. Another roadblock to watch out for is education, dropping out of school. Stay in school. For those of you out there that have kids, to encourage your kids, you know, go to school, finish it out, graduate. You know, another roadblock is peer pressure. Peer pressure, what that means is when you have those ones out there that don't want to succeed, don't let them encourage you or your loved ones to not succeed. Always go out there and do your best and be damn good at it. Those are the roadblocks.
There you go right there, everybody. North Rapid Funnies has some shit to say.
Get out there and fucking pursue your dream and do not fucking stop until it is accomplished.
You know why? Because when you get older, you are our future.
Exactly.
Wow, dude, that was fucking awesome, dude.
Yeah.
I fucking loved it.
Yeah. That's what I had to say.
See, so that comes back to me when, not back to me, but to you and Eddie. We were trying to do something. We wanted to do something. Like a picnic or something.
Yeah.
Next year or this upcoming summer of 2021.
Yeah, like a barbecue.
Yeah. So, how would you guys progress that? I mean, how are you gonna do that? Do you have channels? Do you have people who can actually hook you up and do it?
Well, I could send out a notice to people that I know, and I can let them know what's going on.
Mm-hmm.
And I can ask for donations, you know, donations for, like, say, charcoal, and then, you know, a place where we can barbecue at. And then if people want to attend, we could do things like we could also ask for donations in order to get food. Like, we can get meat, we can get side dishes, we can get drinks, things like that.
Some kamachis, some ramens. No, but brother, I mean, since we're saying this live right now, or not live, you know. I have the sound system. I actually have the sound system. When I say I want to brag about my sound system, like, seriously, I have like 415s, 812s. DJ, I have everything to do the sound system, PA. So if you guys can actually get it going, I got you guys. I'm not gonna back down.
Okay. All right. Well,
and I would not charge you, unless.
Okay.
Unless you want to cuddle, then.
then how much did you charge? Okay. Then how much are you gonna charge then?
Well, it all depends on who's gonna cuddle first.
Ask Gina. I'm just kidding.
Shit. Don't even bring... God, I'm about to edit this out.
Okay, ask Eddie.
He's kind of cheap. He snores too loud.
Jeez.
Oh God. What about you?
I'm taking sorry.
Hey, there's yeah, fuck, never mind. I was gonna say something else.
Oh yeah.
I ain't trying to get gross.
I know. But yeah, I can try to make it happen. I mean, I can reach out to people that I know of, and mm-hmm. I can try to make it happen. I know a lot of people. I know we can make it happen. I can send out a lot of invites even, and we can get this going. Probably, I was probably thinking by, probably early summer.
I was thinking like maybe May, March.
March would be okay. Just got to make sure it ain't fucking snowing still.
Yeah, well, right now I'm looking out the window. It's windy as hell.
Yeah.
So
it was nice. It's been nice out, but I know there's another snowstorm about to roll in here soon.
Oh, shit.
Dang. Yeah, I heard that. Damn. Get the next hydrogen bloom going.
Shit.
It's going to be a disaster, like the one was back then.
Oh, shit. It's your boy, DJ Strick, the DJ Strick Show.
And it's your boy, Waide, of North Rapid Funnies, everybody. Yeah. Well, the thing is that as far as some things go for our page, the biggest stressor is no politics. No politics, yes, exactly. Period. Because...
So I mean, everything, you hear
one time,
that?
One time I tried a political post and it just kind of blew up in our face. We had to delete it. And then we caught some backlash for deleting it. So the thing is that it just doesn't work too well. No politics on it. Because, yeah, granted from what's been happening the past 4 years. Yeah, exactly. There's a lot of sore losers out there now. So, and sore people too. So we just can't do politics on our page.
And I remember one time I was asking you, you should make your own Sprecher, your own podcast, to put it under your guys' name.
I've been thinking about it. I've been thinking about making our own. You know, I mean, I just want to kind of look into it. I've been working 5 days a week, and I get home at 11 o'clock, almost midnight, and I'm tired, and I just want to relax, game a bit, cool, maybe drink a beer.
Cola. I'm a stay-at-home dad. I am a stay-at-home dad. I don't have shit to do. So all I can do is just record my music or, you know, like podcasts.
Yeah.
So basically, I can, if you actually make a channel, you know, a podcast channel.
Yeah.
I would actually, you know, help you out, you know, do the graphic work, graphics, you know.
Right.
Híjole, eso. Mira, es tu bracho.
Yeah, definitely.
Yeah, you know, I don't mind, you know, using my broadcaster page or whatever. Broadcaster, I mean, I don't know, Sprecher or Anchor or whatever. And I love doing this with you guys. I mean, I seriously love doing this with this guy. With, I can't even see it.
Yeah, we enjoy you inviting us to our podcast. Your podcast. I mean, it's been awesome. I mean, the last one that we did together. I mean, we want to do another one where we're all together and in person.
So. That's when it's funny as fuck. Seriously, remember the first one we did?
Yeah, that one was a good one.
That was funny as fuck. I mean, seriously, dude, I was like, what the hell? Is that Waide? Oh my god!
Yeah,
dude, you had me laughing. And then all of a sudden you came from your car and you were like, we got some food.
Yeah.
And then fucking, all that cool and then pork. Fucking Eddie got fucking mad. You fuckers are eating. That's why he got quiet on the fucking podcast. Like, I don't give a shit.
Well, he could have ate too. I mean, that's what we brought it for. I mean, you know, it was leftover food from my 5-year-old's birthday party.
Yeah. But besides,
and it was just sitting in the trunk, and we're like, you know what, we can bring it.
Just the way he said it to me, he was like, "Oh, you fuck you all fuckers! If you're gonna do a podcast, don't eat."
I mean, why not? It wasn't like we were live on video or anything.
Oh, and that's the thing too. That's one thing I want to bring up to you.
Yeah.
Why don't do you feel comfortable? Why don't you? What the hell? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Do you feel comfortable being on video and podcast?
I do. Yeah, I feel comfortable being on video and on podcast.
And dude, look at me. I'm fucking 400 pounds, fluffy as fuck. I don't give a shit. You know, I don't give a shit who looks at me.
I don't think anybody cares what you look like. You know, I mean, what matters is the confidence. You know, to actually be there. I mean, be on the set
in presence,
and be in the spotlight. Yeah. And then actually just be yourself. That's really what it's going to be about.
Okay.
I mean, and they won't, go ahead.
And Danny. Danny boy.
Kohlhoff.
He actually hit me up in the inbox, and he was like, "Oh, I didn't want to be there because, you know, my teeth are looking wrong, or I look fucked up. I didn't want to be there.
My teeth look like shit, but I don't fucking care."
Right?
Yeah.
You know, and then.
I mean, I don't got pearly whites and fucking straight row teeth. I mean.
And then with BJ, you know, BJ or Eddie Brock. He was like, "Nah, I don't want to be on camera because I'm too big." I'm like, "Nah, dude.
It's not how you look, you know. I mean, the thing is that if you're conscious about how you look, I mean, wear a shirt, wear something nice. I mean, I wore my dart shirt that night because I thought I was going to be on camera."
Yeah.
Yeah.
And if you notice, I had all my shit sitting on the by the window. I was like, "Oh, I got this. T-shirt. I got this, you know. I'm just trying to look smooth."
Yeah.
You know, seriously, dude, I'm, like I said, I'm 400 pounds. I don't give a shit. As long as I'm on camera, people are looking at us, shit.
Whatever. Yeah.
And I noticed that about you. That night, you were fucking gung-ho about the fucking podcast. You were like, all about it. You were fucking.
I was looking forward to it because I mean it's my first podcast. I mean, I was a little nervous when we actually started, but you know what?
And then when we got buzzed up, and then you relaxed.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
You did. You relaxed. You were uptight, and then when you got buzzed up, fuck it, boom. Yeah. You was fucking cool as fuck.
It's the way it works. Mm-hmm. I mean, you got to be relaxed and you just got to hit it. So, one thing I want to add is I'd like to say congratulations to South Dakota on the new marijuana ballot that passed.
AKA to all you stoners out there, that means that means you can buy it now or use it now without shrugging your shoulders.
Yep, they have. Well, it goes into effect in July of 2021.
Yes, it's still gonna wait, but still.
Yeah, but it's passed, and I like to talk about the fact that I wish one of my aunts was alive at this time, but she has passed away. She had really bad lupus. She had lupus, and she had really bad rheumatoid arthritis. She was on one leg, and she actually smoked weed to help with her pain and to help her get an appetite. Mm. And I wish she was alive to this day to see this law passed, so that way she could do this, you know, medically, legally. So there would be no pills, things like that to harm your body, because I think pills harm your body.
Oh, I know they do.
I mean, when I was injured about a few years ago, I was on oxycodone for about 3 months, and I lost a lot of weight, and yeah, it wasn't good.
Mm.
Yeah.
Well, this one time I got into a fight with somebody, and they broke my ribs.
Uh-huh.
And I took those oxycodone, something oxy.
There's those hydrocodones or
No, it said Oxy.
Oxycontins or something?
Yeah. And I took three of those. It was like, take the three of these at this time and then go to bed, basically. And those shit, you can still feel the pain, but...
Yeah.
Yeah, when you smoke the green, it's different.
Uh-huh.
Different.
Right, I bet. Yeah, because my injury was caused by a knife attack.
Oh, shit, really?
Yeah, it was a knife attack on my left hand, and then I was getting away from the guy after I got my hand sliced open. I jumped down a flight of stairs to get away, and I shattered my foot when I landed.
Oh, ouch.
Yeah, so I was laid up for about 4 or 5 months. Healing and then going through physical therapy. I mean, my physical therapy sessions, I really liked, I really embraced them because, I mean, I could feel a tremendous amount of pain going through them, but I mean, I like to have my limbs where they're at. That's right. What I said. I mean, I want to walk again. I want to be able to do normal things again. But what really sucks is that I feel pain every day to this day.
You are preaching to the choir.
Yeah, I know. I sound like I am.
No, not to the people, to me.
Uh-huh.
Dude, I was never this big.
Yeah.
I was never this fluffy. When you see me at Eddie's place, remember?
Yeah, I remember that.
Yeah, and when I seen Eddie himself, he's not even Eddie. That's BJ. That's
mm-hmm.
You know, when I seen him, he was big as me.
Yeah.
And then when I seen him and we all, you know, chilled, I was like, dude, seriously, you are that fucking big?
Yeah.
Anyways, what am I getting at? You're talking about size-wise?
Well, it was kind of crazy, though, because it was kind of weird when we were getting ready to do that first podcast because, remember, because when me and Cash showed up at his place, you know, we were going to wait for you. He was going to go get you, and we were going to wait there. Mm. And then all of a sudden, he got an accident just down the road.
Yeah, that's my fault.
No, that's not your fault. That was the other guy's fault. The other guy ran the yield sign. Mm. Okay. The other guy ran the yield sign and plowed right into him. Because he was just going like normal, and then that guy fucking ran the yield sign and hit him, and took the whole front of his van off.
Yeah, dude.
That wasn't your fault because he could have just been going somewhere that day, and the same thing probably would have happened. So don't ever say that's your fault whenever somebody gets in an accident when they're coming to pick you up, because it could have happened to him at that time if he was going out to do some other business. It was a random occurrence. Yeah, I mean, car accidents like that are a random occurrence. I mean, the guy ran a yield sign. I mean, it wasn't Eddie's fault. I mean, Eddie sounded like he won his case.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Because he did say that that guy's insurance company was coughing up some kind of money.
Yeah.
Yeah.
He actually sent me a picture of, what is he, like 3,000...
Yeah, it was a check, probably. It was a check. I remember that.
He sent me a picture. He's like, check it out. I got this going mm-hmm. on. It ain't your fault. Yeah, seriously.
Exactly.
He sent me a picture of, you know, his check. And
right. Said, it ain't your fault. We had a, right. And then me and Cass had a plan. Okay, well, I'm going to come get you. So that's how it went. Because we weren't going to just let this not happen. We wanted it to happen, and then it turned out to be a success.
Oh, for real?
Yeah, the podcast.
No, when I say for real, I mean you actually believe in this podcast because.
Uh huh.
What I told Eddie was, hey, check it out. Not Eddie, BJ.
Yeah.
I was like, dude, let me do a podcast with us, you know? Because remember how you. And I and PJ or Eddie talk shit on Facebook.
Oh, of course.
Remember how we talk shit like that? And I was like,
yeah.
How about we talk shit like that and put it on the podcast?
Yeah.
And that's what we did.
Mm-hmm.
Does that make sense? I know.
Yeah. No, that makes absolute sense. It makes perfect sense.
Because seriously, dude. I mean, you're the, to me, in my eyes, you're the moderator. You're funny, but yet you're like, hold on. Let me check this out.
Well, but, I try to be free reign, you know. I'm like, talk what you want, you know, because this is how it's gonna succeed if we all just be ourselves and just talk how we want.
Yeah. And then it was like Eddie said, or BJ said, he's the jokester, he's the clown, he's the he's the bullshitter that always talks shit. Then you got me. Then you got me, who just abrupt, mm-hmm. and just says it.
Right.
So
I mean, that's how it works.
Yeah. So basically, after that episode, I mean, seriously, I don't know if you actually listened to it.
Uh-huh.
Did you actually listen to that episode?
Yeah, I did.
Yeah, and I kind of get pissed right now, because, not pissed, but like upset, because I know that people don't listen to our podcast.
Well, we just gotta keep going with them, you know.
And that's why I want you to be the manager, or I can be the engineer or audio guy, but I want you to be the manager of everything.
You can be the producer.
Yeah, producer. Yeah. So I have to give you all my passwords and shit.
Yeah, all right. All right, bathroom break.
All right.
I'll take five. Break. Hello, DJ Strick. Okay, everybody, those for you. We're waiting on DJ Strick to get back. I'll go ahead and bring up a few things. Number one, I'd like to say that I appreciate each and every one of you that are so far following North Rapid Funnies. I really appreciate y'all. Refer your friends to us, and when they do, let them know to smash that like button and to smash that follow button. Also, remember to keep following us for the latest up-to-date funny material that we post. Hey, DJ Strick, you back?
Hey, what's up? It's your boy, DJ Strick. Just heard this. He sounds sexy as hell.
And so do you, buddy.
No, hola. Ooh, gotta go bathroom. Gotta eat something. Maintain. Anyways.
Yeah.
Go back, but hold on. Let me broadcast this
from the 605 to worldwide. It's DJ Strick.
All right, it's your boy DJ Strick. Other DJ Strick girl, DJ Strick show. Chilling with homeboy Waide
and Waide from North Rapid Funnies, ladies and gentlemen.
There you go. See, I was waiting for you to say that.
All right. I was thinking about the other day. There was somebody who was about to back into a pole in their car. It was a really expensive looking car. And then I actually had him stop, you know, because I told him to stop because he was about to back into it. So the guy thanked me. So he went to leave, and this was in the Walmart parking lot the other day. Well, I was sitting there coming to think about it, because if it was any other native, they would have just watched him back into that pole. Mm. And then they would have yelled at the guy, "Hey, I know someone who can fix that."
You can't take him nowhere.
No, you really can't sometimes.
Seriously, I am upset, you know, about those people. Look at me. I'm this native. I'm this part native. I'm this native. And yet they're fucking complaining about, oh, we're something else.
You know what?
We are actually, something else.
You know what? I actually found it funny being something else because...
No, dude, I'm for something else.
I can go for a something else taco right about now.
Oh, shit. Oh, are you trying to be racist?
No.
See, that's fucked up. Me being half Mexican and half Lakota, you know.
Uh-huh.
You know, just, people try to talk shit like, oh, I'm going to go to Taco John's. That's my beaner, you know, food. I was like,
yeah.
Seriously? Really? You realize who you're talking to? Anyways, what are you, dude, what are you trying to do?
Well, all I was just trying to go ahead.
Oh, no, we're like an hour recording in this, so.
Yeah, I just thought it was funny, you know, when CNN called natives something else. I'm not sure if they're referring to just natives or probably everybody else that they didn't, you know, talk about.
What I heard was it wasn't just natives. It was the Dakota natives. They were like, oh, shit, those are Dakota natives. They don't like to be called Indians. So put it as something else. And that was on CNN. That was on CNN.
They were trying, yeah, I guess they were trying to not sound so whatchamacallit. But you know the thing
racist
is Yeah, you know what I mean. And they just kind of they still use the wrong terminology, I think. But then again, though, us natives we went and ran with it.
And we ran with it. Dude, that's fucking funny as hell.
Oh. Yeah, we laughed about it, and I thought it was funny, too. Okay, well, dude, I went to bed native last night. I went to bed native last night, and I woke up with something else.
I'm like, seriously? Am I Mexican? Am I fucking native, or am I something else? You see my memes. I seen your... Oh, my God. I seen North Rapid Funnies fucking memes.
Mm-hmm.
They were fucking terrible. I mean, when I say terrible... That's in a good way.
Right. We use terrible in a good sense because nowadays, you know, a lot of things in the world are terrible. So what are you going to do with terrible? You want to try to laugh at it because if you laugh at it, you're going to feel better about it.
And when you're half native or when you're not even fucking half native, when you're native, we fucking make jokes about it. We fucking... do shit, you know. I don't know how to explain it to you. Hola, seriously, it's just like, you know, like my post earlier, it says CNN can't name natives /
exactly
Indian country your cheeks. Seriously?
Yeah, I've seen that. CNN canning natives. That's actually pretty good. I actually laughed at that when I saw that.
Yeah, seriously. They don't know our lifestyle. And, oh, dude. Okay, let's get real. Let's get real right now. Ready? Ready? 1, 2, 3, 4, and.
Good.
Oh, look at me. I'm Cherokee. I'm this tribe. I'm Ogala. I'm Lakota, Nakota, Dakota. I'm not something else. It's like, seriously, why on the fuck are you saying I'm not something else?
You know, I find it funny because whenever I hear somebody say that they're Cherokee, you know the song from Cher? Cherokee people. Oh. Cherokee people. So proud to live. Yeah, I was thinking of that too, and I was like, I always kind of laugh to myself whenever I hear that, you know, because, I mean, maybe there are people. I mean, there are people out there that are Cherokee, you know. I mean, no offense, but the thing is that I don't know. It's just a song I think about whenever I hear someone. Yeah, I'm a quarter Cherokee, or I'm an eighth Cherokee. You know, I'm like, oh, okay. I mean, that's all. That's my answer. Is, oh, okay, and then I think of that song.
No. That's not what I was saying. What I was saying is people who are saying, we're not, what the how you call it, dude?
What's that? You're not what?
We're not. What the hell is that fucking meme? Dude, I'm fucking getting drunk.
Yeah, I don't know what you're trying. I don't know what you're trying to
what
talk
the hell
about.
What was that meme? What was that fucking meme?
Yeah, I don't know. Excuse me, I can't think of it right now.
Yeah, you're getting drunk too. What are you sipping on?
Mm-hmm. I'm sipping on this Limerita still.
Oh shit! Oh, you. You're gonna poop later.
Yeah, I'm buzzing.
It's only 2 o'clock.
Yeah.
What are you? Dude, it's fucking windy as hell right here.
Is it?
Yeah. So whatever you whatever you had, it's coming over here.
I farted in that wind, so you're going to get it here shortly.
Hey, it smells like grapes. It smells sweet.
Well, that wasn't mine because I didn't eat no grapes. Well, I had a couple of donuts, but...
Well, then your butthole must smell stink. Don't go wrong. Go good.
Oh, yeah, I can't think of the meme that you're trying to talk about.
I know, I'm supposed to sit sitting here fucking drunk as fuck. Like, what the hell meme is...
Yeah, well, what was I going to say?
I don't know. What I'm going to say is...
I think I'm...
You are on... your own podcast with me, DJ Strick, of the DJ Strick Show. It's not even live right now, dude. It's recording. So we can edit out. Yeah, it's done, dude. So, yeah, go ahead and speak.
Yeah. All right. Well, I kind of think we'll probably go ahead and wrap it up here. All I got to say is that to those out there who are listening tonight, please keep following our page, North Rabbit Funnies. Look, if you already have it, let your friends know about it. Let your loved ones know about it. Look us up. Hit that like button and smack and hit that follow button as well. You know, I mean, definitely take a look because we're there to provide you with a lot of laughs. You know,
humor.
If you're having a bad day,
humor for the North Side. Yes.
Check us out. We're gonna make you laugh. We're gonna make your day better.
There.
So, once again, this is Waide. I am the lead admin of North Rapid Funnies. I created the page about a year and a half ago, and I wasn't sure how far it would go when me and Eddie Brock created it. And right now, we are nearing 20,000 followers, and that is amazing. I never thought we'd get so many people, and we would like to definitely have more people follow us and like us. So, once again, if you guys have any friends out there that need a good laugh, let them know about us. Again, smash that like button and smash those follow buttons on us.
Do the link.
All right. It is facebook.com/NorthRapidFunnies. I mean, check that out. It's there.
I would add that in. I would edit that kind of shit in. And then once again, you're listening to your boy right here, Miguel John of DJ Strick of the DJ Strick Show. I am kind of cross-eyed, not feeling good inside, but we have Waide of North Rapid Funnies on my podcast. Seriously, one of the coolest dudes you guys could ever meet. Seriously, if you ever meet him in person, you will get a boner, or your nipples will get hard.
Everybody, thanks for listening.
But I think we're gonna let it go right here because I'm getting too fucked up. And then I'll call you back on your phone.
Okay, sounds good.
All right. I love you, babe.
Yeah. All right, bro. Have a good one.
One. Right. YouTube.com, DJ Shirk 2. Facebook.com, The Rev Miguel John. Facebook.com, Miguel John, Own Stop Records. Twitter, Miguel John. Instagram, MiguelJohn.78. And at TikTok, Miguel John Castillo.